welcome to our very first Python programming lesson. So without further ado, let's just jump into this and get started. So I'm using the Sublime text editor. So why don't I go ahead and show you how to get that installed? That way you can just follow along with me. So what you want to do is go to the sublimetext.com website. Go to the download section. Find the appropriate installation file for your operating system. I'm going to show you how to do this for Linux because it's pretty straightforward for Windows. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and copy the link location. I'm going to open up a terminal here, and then we're going to use the wget command, and then we're going to paste the download link, and we're going to download that file to our system. Once the file is downloaded, we will use the following command, dpkg space dash I, and the download file. Go ahead and hit enter, and this will install Sublime Text. Once that is complete, your Sublime Text editor is installed. Perfect. Okay, once you have Sublime Text editor open, click View at the top, scroll down to Syntax, and select Python. This will ensure that the text is color-coded appropriately for the Python programming language, and this will make it a lot easier for you to read the source code. Installing programs is no fun, so let's write our first program. And as with tradition, we're going to write the Hello World program. And this is kind of a rite of passage for anybody learning how to program. It's generally the first program that you write. Python makes this really simple. In order to print something to the screen, all we need to do is use the print function, followed by the text that we would like to use enclosed in quotes. So as you see here, that's exactly what we have. And this is a complete Python program. We can now save this file to our computer. Then you can see we have our file here. Why don't we give it an appropriate name? We'll call it Hello World, and we can see it there. Let's get rid of that untitled. All right, perfect. So now we have our Python script. It's on our hard drive. Now we want to actually execute it and run it. So in order to do that, we need the Python interpreter to process the code and run it. So to do that, we're going to do the following. We'll type Python, followed by our script. And we'll press enter. And as you can see, our Python script has ran and it has exported the text Hello World. Now, if you don't want to have to type Python in front of your script in order to run the program, you need to add the Python interpreter to your script file. So we'll do that now. Okay, this is the code right here that basically designates we're setting an interpreter. And then the next set of text is the actual location. In this instance, on my system, the Python binary is in user bin Python. So we're going to go ahead and save this file. And now we're going to attempt to execute our program. By using the following. We need to make the file executable. Because if the file is not executable, you will not be able to run the Python script as you can see here, as it's not going to process the interpreter. So we'll make the file executable. And now we will again attempt to execute our file. And as you can see, this time our file ran. It exported the text, "Hello World." There you have it, guys, your very first Python script. That's going to do it for today, but I have more Python videos coming up, so please stay tuned. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you want to see my future videos, be sure to subscribe so you get notifications. And I will see you guys on the other side.